just a day hike, and I got some knives I want to test and get a fire going and stuff. Wet day, we're gonna see how I do out here today. It's soaked. Everything's really wet right now, so it's gonna be harder to find dry wood. We're gonna show some batoning as well, so stay tuned. So I found my spot. Here it is. I've got this tree right here, and I've got this tree over here. I'm gonna show you how I bug out and camp in this sort of situation. The lake is right here, so it's not really the best spot, just because the wind coming off the lake and whatnot. But I'm safe from thunder. If the situation did occur where there was thunder, I'm pretty safe in here because of these tall trees. I'm gonna find some deadwood. There's one right there that looks like a good candidate. And we'll start doing some batoning tests here, and stay tuned. It's going to be interesting in the wet and in the cold rain, so stay tuned.
Right off the bat, I got to clear this tree here because this is where my tarp's going to go. So I got to clear some of these limbs with the Bear Gryll's ultimate survival knife. With the serrations off, I might add. So I'm going to try and... not gonna try and limb a whole lot. That one. I think I'll take this one right here, just because it's at my head height. Yeah. So that did pretty good. Bear Gryll's ultimate survival knife. So that's all I'm going to clear from that side. Over on this side, there's not really a whole lot. That one, actually two, three. So three limbs I'm going to take off. This one here, I'm going to try and stay away from killing any dead stuff as much as possible anyways. Maybe say you can see the moisture in this. In this log, even underneath the bark, it's soaked. That one of them is a stick. That's where the serrations are coming in on that back cut. Alright. It's doing pretty good. I'm having a little bit of grip trouble with it being a little bit wet. So far I doubt it's doing well. Alright. I'm gonna leave this one the way it is. This tree over here, this big one, I'm not going to bother with that one at all. Just going to get my tent up first, or my tarp up first, like I would in a regular camping trip. I'm just going to show you how I do it, and some different things that I do with my tools, and so stay tuned, it's going to be good. Camera's getting a little wet, I might throw a bag over it, so here we go. Hopefully you guys can still hear me okay. It's not too terribly windy out here. It's still fairly early in the morning, but I had to put the camera over the bag to keep the moisture off of it. I don't want to wreck it, so. This knife is doing pretty well. Pretty surprising, actually. But the grip really slickened up as soon as I got moisture on it, so that's something to look out for. But I'm gonna tie up my string and I'm gonna show you what exactly to do right over here. So I gotta dig up my pack here. I got some pink twine. I know it's pink, but it works. And then after I get this up, I'll show you what exactly I have in here all. So here's my rope that I'm going to be using. Dig up my tarp as well. Also remember to pack out all your garbage when you're done. That'll come a little later when we get the fire going. So, actually I'm going to come over here because this is where I'm going to start. It's over here. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to put my rope right around here. Right in this big branch here. Right around this big branch here, and I'm just gonna do, you can do any sorts of knots. So I'm just gonna wrap it, feed it through a loop, come around the fisherman's knot, even though we're not fishing. But it works great for this sort of thing, because it gives you a good base knot to come off of. So I'm gonna do that, first of all, get it right nice, close to the tree, and then I'm going to string this across and we'll come over here. I'm going to take my spool with me. We're going to come over to this end. Up here. To right here, this tree. Once again, sorry for the reduced quality. I know it's pretty bad. You got to do it. Because if not, my camera's going to get haggard. So we're going to come up and around. Once again, you guys can see. Up. And we're just going to do one loop around the tree. This is where it's good to have smaller trees. And then just pull it as tight as I can. Really snug. And then I'm going to wrap it again around here. Come out, and that one loop that I did around it will actually hold that string nice and tight, and then I can do my knot. So reaching to my pocket corner, I got my favorite everyday carry knife on me here today. She's the Buck Vantage Select. I'm gonna cut it out here a little bit. Once again, don't throw out this string when you get home. This is a good rope. Use it in other situations as well, so don't throw it out. No, I wouldn't. And then you just want to tie it, come back, just hold your knot there with your finger, and then come back again. Just a regular square knot is all I need for that. And do a couple, just to be sure that it's not going to come down. All right, getting ready to throw up my tarp here. I didn't make all four, because I realized that some of these logs in through here, take off my shirt here, some of these logs in through here I can utilize for tent poles. We're going to try it. We're going to try and see how it works. I got my tarp here, and I'm just going to yank it out. Get it right around half. once again, if I were in this situation, I probably would have another tarp to put on the ground because it is so wet.
So I got it strung up about halfway. See there? On my string. So I'm good to go. I can start pulling out my ends here. So stay tuned. I'm going to show you what I do on one end. And then do it by myself off camera. Just so it doesn't get boring. So stay tuned.